Right now, though, let's talk real estate, shall we? You've probably heard in the news about how Vancouver Island's housing market is heating up, and there will be much discussion and speculation about that. And we're also still waiting for the next set of numbers and stats to be released by the finance ministry when it comes to real estate in this province. And the thing is, there are a lot of numbers out there, and breaking them all down and trying to figure out what they mean can be tough. So, to demystify the latest numbers about the housing market, we are joined now by Steve Soretsky, who's a realtor at Sutton Group West Coast Realty and who also writes about this online. Steve, thanks for being here.
Hey, Simi. Thanks for having me.
Now, you've kind of gone out of your way to try to break down all these different numbers out there. Why is that?
There's a little bit of a debate the other day on Twitter, basically comparing some of the real estate board's stats they had released. And then a brokerage here in Vancouver called Zolo had to release their stats, and they were quite conflicting. So basically, I just kind of delved into both of them, looked at both sides, and then kind of gave my analysis.
Okay, and so what did you find?
So basically, I mean, they just, like, Zolo was looking at their numbers using, like, an average, which, I mean, average is generally, like, the most accurate way to look at prices. I mean, like, I think median sales price is usually a better way to look at it. I mean, really, there's no, like, exact 100% bulletproof, you know, way to look at the sales numbers, but I think that median is the most accurate. So, I mean, basically, to summarize, what I found is that, you know, it kind of confirms what I've been seeing, is that basically since April, the detached sales have really started to slow down, and that's been on a downward trend since April. Sales prices for the detached houses, you know, dropping slightly, not much. So there's not a whole lot of movement there. And then the same thing for condos. I mean, those are still hanging on pretty good. Like downtown condos, I mean, those are still multiple offers. Prices haven't moved. And yeah, it still remains quite active.
Right. And you mentioned the real estate board there too, because there's a big difference in what they think is going on versus what other people think is going on, isn't there?
Yeah, well, I mean, like, everybody has, like, you know, their thoughts and whatnot, and so some people obviously believe that the real estate board has a way of, you know, fanning the flames and trying to make everything look kind of rosy. So that's why when they were looking at Zolo's numbers were, you know, they were saying that month over month prices were down like 12%. But when you look at average numbers like that, those numbers can fluctuate quite a bit just depending on what kind of housing was actually sold that month.
Right. So do you think, Steve, that we are slowing down in the Metro Vancouver housing market?
Yeah, no doubt. No doubt. I think it's very evident. I think it was already slowing, and I've said this before, it was already slowing, but since the introduction of the tax, it kind of just changed some of the mentality, locals. So I think that kind of escalated things. Like I said, we were already seeing a downward trend, and this just kind of added to it.
Yeah, changed the mentality how, though?
I think a lot of it, I mean, you know, obviously there is a lot of foreign capital coming in, but a lot of it was driven by, you know, fear of missing out amongst the locals, right? People see prices going up, and the psychology is, okay, well, I better jump in now before it's too late. And, you know, with that happening, so now all of a sudden they introduce this tax, they see that reports coming out that sales are slowing, so now everyone's going, oh, hold on, maybe I shouldn't jump in just yet, maybe I should wait.
It sounds like, and the way you're putting it is that we really are just lemmings in all of this.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's basic human psychology, human behavior, right? You follow what other people are doing, and I think that's been a huge driver for this market.
Yeah. Okay. So you think it is definitely slowing down out there. Is that going to stay, do you think? Are we going to see more of that in the fall?
It's hard to say. I mean, I don't like to predict. It's because nobody really knows. But, I mean, if you look at the numbers, I mean, the sales have been dropping since April. Like, this isn't just like a 1 or 2 month thing. Like, this is, I don't know how much you can rebound this, where we have that foreign tax. You have a vacancy tax coming in here for Vancouver anyways. So I think those two things as well. And I think more and more headlines and are going to come out and say, you know what, hey, look, sales are dropping. And I think that's just going to, you know, caution people right. Even more.
It's interesting that you say sales are dropping since April, because I would say that February and March were probably the big kind of frenzied months, right, in the market when we really started talking about it. It seems like every single day, and there were all these outrageous stories going on, and it brought all that attention to the market. So maybe it did have an impact.
Oh, absolutely. I think February and March were definitely the busiest months. And like I said, I mean, as soon as headlines start to come out and saying, wow, prices are going up, it's getting busy, like, people, like, start to panic. And, I mean, you know, I guess, you know, rightfully so. And so everyone wanted to jump in on the market. And like I said, now you're seeing those headlines coming out saying sales are dropping. There's something interesting to note on that is I noticed, interesting fact, basically, that 33% of Canadian home sales, so when they report home sales for all of Canada, 33% of that is made up of British Columbia. And so even if sales prices don't drop, but if sales slow down where we have less sales, like, that's going to impact the overall national average for home sales.
That's amazing, so when you think about it.
Yeah, so you're going to see, basically, I'm sure reports will come out saying, oh, Canadian national home prices, sales, or price drop 10% or whatever the number is. And that's all going to be reflected to BC, not because BC prices have come down, but because BC is selling less homes, and that's going to affect the national average.
Right. Okay. So essentially there is a bit of a slowdown going on right now. And I guess when we get into September, we'll get a better idea of where we sit, because August is generally a slow month. And so we'll see what the market does when September comes.
Yeah, exactly. September usually picks up. And I think people are, yeah, like I said, kind of waiting to see what happens next with the market since the introduction of the tax. But
yeah,
I think September will give us a really good sense of where we're heading.
Sounds like we're going to be talking to you again then, Steve. Thanks for your time.
Awesome. Yeah, thanks for having me, Simi.
That is Steve Soretsky, a realtor at Sutton Group West Coast Realty, who also writes about these issues and stuff online when it comes to the real estate market. And yes, it'll give us lots more to talk about.
Listen to CKNW anywhere, anytime at CKNW.com or with the CKNW app.